I decided to retire in 2009. I decided in 2009 because I wanted to take a year after being an Olympic gold medalist to go out and have fun. I wanted to just race without the pressure that I had on my shoulders for 4 years. After I retired, my husband and I wanted to have a family. People asked me, why do you want to come back? You've already won a gold medal. I wanted to have my son on the podium with me. That was my vision, that was my dream. It's what got me up every morning to train, is to think that my 2-year-old son can be on the podium with me. Going back to an Olympic Games after winning a gold medal is really difficult. The media hype that happens prior to, the expectations that happen, the pressure, is something that you really need to learn to cope with and try to channel it out. Competing in London in 2012 was very special. In the sport of cycling, in women's cycling, I've never had the crowds or the fans, or you can call them super fans. I've never had that much excitement around our sport in any competition I've ever competed in. The roads were very different than 2008 in Beijing. They were very rolling, they were flat. And so one of the things on this course, because there wasn't the ups and downs and it wasn't too technical, you have to really focus much more on a course like this because you can get lost with long straightaways. But during this time, where the aerodynamics during this ride were really important. I went to the wind tunnel several times, and as you can see, the straightaways and making sure that I take the quickest and straightest line so that I can maximize the advantage that I had over my competitors. Sometimes my mantra is, are you hurting more than everyone else? Are you feeling good? If you're feeling good, you're probably not winning the race. My best races are when I feel like I can't even get out of my own way. And so the mind in the time trial is really, really important. One of the competitors that I caught at the very end was Marianne Vos. And there was a straightaway and it was turning to the right slightly. And I didn't want to pass her on the left because it would take me maybe another second to pass her, so that wasn't the most direct way for me. So at the same time, I decided to pass her on the right-hand side. She started coming in to take the same line I did. And it looks, as when you're watching the video, it looks like she's gonna come in on top of me and I was gonna go into the curb. And that was within a K to go of the race. And I didn't realize how close it was until I watched it. And at the end, there was a corner to go with 50 meters mark, and I stood up, I sprinted, because I kept on saying that I have to live with this result. When I go to bed tonight, this is it. And when I knew that I was the last racer to go, I knew that my number was one, and I knew that I saw that I won the race. It was a phenomenal feeling.
Oh my God.
I wouldn't say that my second gold medal was any easier. In fact, I would say that it was harder. And because of the emotional piece of it, it meant just as much to me. What woke me up every morning in the really cold, frigid mornings was a vision of having Lucas on the podium with me, and he was gonna be 2 years old at the time. And everything was aligned, and I won the gold medal, and they took me back, they scurried me back and got me all ready to get on to the podium. And I didn't know what was gonna happen. My family was with Lucas, I knew security was tight, and we were out on the podium, and the only thought I had was I was looking out in the crowd and I was going through everybody's faces, looking for my parents, looking for my husband, and looking for my son. And there was a moment where I looked over and I saw Lucas. And my husband let him down and we let him do what he did, which was run to me. And everyone just paused and looked, and he ran right up, and that was the picture perfect moment. Nobody did anything, nobody said anything, they just all watched. And I think it was just a moment in time that nobody could take away. He was, for a moment, just that perfect little boy. Didn't really quite know what was going on. I let him bite my metal. In fact, I still have teeth marks on my metal. And they look like little scratch marks, but it was from him biting it. And he still talks about mommy's gold medal. And I didn't know if he'd understand at age two, but he seems to know that I went really hard on my bike and I won a gold medal. And it's not chocolate. We'll be right back.